Yo, Pierre, you wanna come out here?
Come on!
Hello everybody, welcome to another episode of Yo Pierre, your favorite weekly Arsenal podcast. Every week, a group of gunners from different parts of the world will discuss, analyze and argue over topics related to our favorite club Arsenal in Tonguish, a mix of English and Tamil. We have great episodes every week, so listen on!
So hello and welcome to episode 6 of Yo Pierre, your weekly Arsenal podcast. Joining me again today is Praveen. Welcome back, Praveen. And again,
hello.
Last week we have Arvind joining us again from Jersey City. So guys, how you doing?
Hey, super man, super. How are you?
Good man, good, good. We're positive, improved international break so long. We didn't have any casualties. Abba didn't play for the Gabon game, so no casualties there. Barty had a pretty good game against Mali. So everything was fine except for this, KT quarantine thing. So, paakalam, how things go. So, today we have a very interesting topic. So, we've just been talking about we had a transfer window to talk about and we had the games going on and all that. So, the transfer window is completely slammed shut and we are at the point where the international break is also over. PL is coming back this weekend. The point now is we don't have any more additions from now on till January. And, this target of top four finish for the season. And only LRM, right from the manager to all the players, everyone's talking about the same thing. So, I just thought it would be interesting to compare our current squad with the last time we finished in the top four. Just to see how we can expect to fare this season. One more thing is the season that we are going to compare with was a very bizarre season. So, many external factors on this. We'll try to factor them in. We'll try to make our predictions for the top six relegation and then finish with the preview for the city game. Number squad only in there. We'll also see what else happened in that season, okay? So, number last time we finished fourth, you guys must be remembering, not fourth, in the top four.
Leicester win panna idu vandha, I think we finished second, right?
Yes, we finished second. It was in the top four, I mean. Last time we finished top four. The last time we finished.
Oh, okay, okay.
It's interesting, right? We finished second and, Tottenham, funny, they finished third in a two-horse title race.
Yes.
I think as a good,
satisfying
thing that can happen for us to see is either Spurs finish below us or guess what, due to something they did. The famous lasagna incident, that's the most fun part. 2015, we really didn't have anything to do. We just totally imploded. And in spite of our best efforts, we finished second. We were nowhere in the picture, suddenly we finished second. So, Leicester வந்து அவங்களோட ஒரு fairy tale season இருந்தது. இதுல முக்கியமான விஷயம் என்னன்னா, Leicester finished first, we finished second, we were 10 points behind them. So, இது வந்து கொஞ்சம் note பண்ண வேண்டிய விஷயம். நம்ம finished second, finished பண்ணாலும் 10 points behind. Arsenal finished 1 point behind us. And, if I remember right, City was the last team, top four on the season finished பண்ணது. அப்ப அதுக்கு அடுத்த சீசன் தான் நம்ம கடைசியா சாம்பியன்ஸ் லீக் பார்த்தது. Forcing myself to enjoy it and trying to sing along. I feel this is the worst thing that could happen from what happened to the club. So, just to see, But we'll try and compare each department and go into see if they're actually better than what we were before. And can we expect another similar close finish? Okay. So we finished on 71 points. We scored 65 goals in the season there. We led in 36. The 65 and 36 are very important if you guys may be kind enough to remember that. அதுக்கப்புறம் வந்து சாம்பியன்ஸ் லீக்ல
what's 36? What's that?
We scored 65 goals in the season, league only. 65,
okay.
And we led in 36.
Oh, okay. Okay. Mm-hmm.
Okay. And the rest of the results that we had in the season, we went out in the knockouts in CL, FA Quarters, League Cup, Portugal. So, okay. The point is, 65 goals and 36 conceded. எதுக்கு நான் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் பார்த்தேன்னா, just to give you guys an idea of what all happened in the subsequent seasons. The very next season, we finished 5th. We scored 77, but we conceded 44. Okay. அதுக்கப்புறம் again 74 and 51, 73 and 51, அதுக்கப்புறம் 56 and 48. So our point, and as you can see, we've been conceding more and more goals since that season. Okay. So அதுல தான் வந்து we are going to start now. அதுக்கு just before we start, ஒரு certain things that were constant during that season was that we were mostly playing 4-3-1. Almost all of the games we were playing 4-3-1. அப்புறம் வந்து we just had two senior players in. அப்பதான் we got check and we were happy that we got a goalkeeper for the next 5 years and we were going to win everything in sight. And we got Elneny, who is like the guy who does anything we want.
Check 2016
2017
Okay.
So on the season the regular starting 11 only, it was very simple. Check, Monreal, Koscielny, Matuschak or Gabriel, Bayern. அப்புறம் இட் வாஸ் இதர் ராம்சே ஆர் சாண்டி காக் ஓசில் சான்சேஸ் ஜிரு அண்ட் தியோ ராம்சே. சோ இது ஜஸ்ட் டு கிவ் யூ கைஸ் தி ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஐடியா. நம்ம வந்து ஃபர்ஸ்ட் டீம் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் 11 தான் இருக்கு. சோ ஸ்குவாட் பத்தி வி சீ தி அதர் பிளேயர்ஸ் ஹூ ஆர் தேர் இன் தி ஸ்குவாட், பட் ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஜஸ்ட் லுக் அட் தி யூ நோ சிமிலர் சினாரியோ தட் வி ஹேவ் ஓவர் ஹியர், சிமிலர் ஜஸ்ட் டு சீ வாட்ஸ் ஹேப்பனிங். இந்த சீசன் வந்து வி காட் கேப்ரியல், பாரி, வில்லியன், சுவாரஸ் மாரி, அஞ்சு பேர், 5 சீனியர் பிளேயர்ஸ். So, and the team pretty much right now, which even if we go to assuming that they're going to a 4-2-3-1, looks like it's going to be Leno, KP, Gabriel, Lewis Holding and Barron, Party, Xhaka, Ceballos, Saka, Alba, Laka and Pepe William. Okay? So, this is the background. I've given you guys that right now to work our team. So, first, goalkeepers. Let's start comparison with the goalkeepers. Now, Sonna Mari, when we got checked that season, we were all like, you know, hoping that he was going to be like this champion keeper would take us to the next level. He was not bad. He was pretty good in the first two seasons that he played. After he slowly started to deteriorate. So, back then we had Czech. We finished second. We conceded just 36 goals in that season. Now we have Leno, who again is supposedly like a better keeper. So, umbrella thoughts in between Czech and Leno, you know, like from what all we've seen. You know, Leno spent a good 2-3 seasons with us, I think now. So, we have seen a good amount of him. We know how to assess him. So, Igula, Czech and Leno comparisons.
So, yeah. So, Czech is definitely a legend. Okay. He was okay. He's a match winner. He's won titles. He has experience at the back. To be honest, what I felt was Arsenal didn't have money, okay, and they just need some keeper who can immediately have an impact in the Premier League, and that's one reason I think Czech came in. We cannot doubt his abilities, his capabilities with the goalie or the capabilities alone. You cannot doubt at all. When Czech came up, when he was with Wenger, it was all fine. But things started going backward when Emery pitched in. அப்பதான் வந்து நம்மளுக்கு அந்த சனியே ஆரம்பிச்சது. When he started playing from back and நம்ம எல்லா பிளேயர்ஸும் இதுனா, you have to see, whenever he gets the ball, the moment he gets the ball, we all get that scare feeling. Okay, what is he going to do next? அந்த ஒரு ஃபீல் வந்துட்டே இருந்தது. So, Emery, he has spoiled everything, okay, and அங்கிருந்து அழிவுக்காக ஆரம்பிச்சது நம்மளுக்கு. And to compare with Leno, Leno invariably is better than check-in in distributing. Distribution is better than check. Savings is pretty young.
Distribution layer. Distribution layer, like you mean like when playing out from the back or general
playing, long playing out, playing out from the back. Distribution layer, okay, but playing out from the back, Leno is better than check.
But that doesn't say a lot though. Even Leno's not that great.
You have to consider when Czech came to us. Czech was pretty old that time. Okay, if you compare Czech when he was in prime in Chelsea, and when you compare what he was doing with Arsenal, you have to see his age, right? Number idhula vandha the first season la mattum dhaan prime irundha idarna. Adukapram I don't think he was doing really well. With Leno, he's young, definitely he's been doing well for our club after he has come back. And with current, the way the football is going, I think he fits well with Arsenal current strategically. So, on the time, with Wenger, I would say check. But right now, I don't think his game style would fit. But number Ipo, I go with Leno.
So Arvind, Pravin sonna point la vandu, he said like, you know, he plays out from the back and all that. So I don't know, Czech struggled as soon as we started playing out from the back. As soon as Emery started playing out from the back, Czech vandu, Pravin sonna mari, it was a struggle for him. Leno again, he's a little better in that aspect, little better in the rumba little, very little. On the point la vandu, it's again, a team that is trying to establish an identity by playing out from the back. So, like, Leno, is he going to, like, you know, kind of be a weak link because he's an amazing short stopper, but the problem with him is he never commands his goal. He never, like, commands the defender. He's not vocal. So, will that, do you think that will end up, like, hindering our chances, given the philosophy that the team plays with?
So, ippo current ah paathana, it is going to be a little, that old comparison would not hold water. Ena, appo vandu, remember the very first few games that Czech was in goal, he would almost score an own goal trying to do a back pass to a defender. So, andamari or a situation, then now we are consistently playing a very high line, in so high that சில சிச்சுவேஷன்ல லெனோ இஸ் ஃபோர்ஸ் டு பிளே அ ஸ்வீப்பர் கீப்பர். சோ வித் தட் செட், ஆல்சோ கன்சிடர் த ஃபேக்ட் தட் லெனோ வாஸ் 24 வென் ஹி கேம் டு ஆர்சனல், நவ் இஸ் 27. சோ ஹி ஹாஸ் தட் ஏஜ் அண்ட் எக்ஸ்பீரியன்ஸ் அஸ் வெல். ஹி இஸ் அண்டர்ஸ்டுட் த டீல் ஆஃப் த பிரீமியர் லீக், ஹவு பிசிக்கல் இட் இஸ் அண்ட் ஹவு த காம்படிஷன் இஸ். சோ ஐ திங்க் ஹேவிங் செட் ஆல் ஆஃப் தட், லெனோ டெஃபினெட்லி கிவ்ஸ் அஸ் அ மேசிவ் edge, especially he would have something to prove because Martinez finished last season at such a height and we sold Martinez this season. People seem to forget the fact that before Leno got injured, he was leading the league in number of shots faced and number of save in the save percentage per game. So, அப்படி இருந்துட்டு your game cannot fall off a cliff so bad that that you become absolutely flawless. I think that there is only one way to go for Leno, and that is upwards. Also, what is very encouraging is the fact that when Czech was our keeper, he saved one penalty, and that was I think it's 200 clean sheet if I'm not wrong. Right. He would save Roy Deeney's penalty at home. That was his only penalty save with Arsenal. All the other saves, somehow it would have hit the bar during a cup game or something, but that was his only save. Leno, in the Carabao Cup, he had two saves against Liverpool. So, I think he's also becoming a better penalty shot stopper as well. Inaki Kana's presence definitely does seem to help. He's positioning himself better. He's able to read the ball well. He's already swept a couple of balls in the Premier League this season. So I think the only way for Leno to go this season is up.
Okay. So while we're on the topic of goalkeepers, I just want to bring in a point about the remaining members in the squad. So we had a second goalkeeper. The last time we finished in the top four was Ospina. The guy was quality. Now we have a second goalkeeper in the form of Bruno Silva. and I have no idea what he does. So, if we're in a situation, I don't know how to put this, but like Leno ko or chinna keeral vanda kuda, I think the season will be done.
Macha vaaya vekkada dayu seidha. True, very true. I'm pretty sure he's gonna start in Europa. Europa and the starting league matches, I think he'll start.
Who, Renarsson or Leno?
Renarsson.
Hmm.
He will at least start the first couple of matches and we'll get a fair idea how he's doing. And upper gauge panla nikra.
So, Arvind, do you think that it's going to be Renarsson starting in the league? Because the way I see it now, I'm disagreeing with you, Pravin, on this. I think for the few games, at least in the future, it's going to be Leno as number one.
No, in Europa.
I'm talking even in Europa, I think it's going to be Leno for some time.
At least for a couple of matches, I think he'll be there. The first few matches, I think Ronaldo will play. You cannot let Leno play all the matches. You cannot be.
That's true. True, but I think that's the problem we are left with now. That is what I feel. What do you guys think? I feel that because of, you know, like in the Renaissance or the stats and everything, the way he plays and all that, I think Leno is going to be like under a lot of pressure for this season.
So, he was a backup goalkeeper for his old club also, right? I don't think he was number one, Renaissance.
He started,
okay. So, honestly, I haven't seen him play, I have fairly no idea about how he's gonna do with us, but I think for some reason we would have taken him. Either quality irko, maybe his play from back or maybe his distribution is good. We have to see how he's gonna do. But I'm pretty sure he's gonna start with Europa. Let's see how, whether நீ சொல்றது கரெக்டா இருக்கா நான் சொல்றது கரெக்டா இருக்கா பார்க்கலாம்
பார்வை என்ன சொல்றான் பார்வை
so Runarsson is 25 he's got good height 6'1" but he's fairly light in terms of weight
exactly say, yeah
that is nimble footed or you know the corners or the set pieces எடுக்கணும்னா you have like huge defenders in the Premier League and you need that physical presence inside at 168 udina like Maguire mari orthan kitta odi vandale kida vendra mari irukav so I think he's a very raw product but the fortune or the thing that goes with Praveen's point for him to start Europa League games is our Europa League group is like a bunch of nobody with us so and we don't have a lot of traveling to do so that probably signals to me that he might get a game or two at least initially. If we are in a much comfortable position, then he'll probably see out the entire group stage and we'll get Leno for the knockouts. But having said that, initial rendu moonu game, or I wouldn't say moonu game kuda romba kashtam, rendu game ama abhinathom pannana, then he'll probably warm the bench for the rest of the season.
Yeah.
Okay, so இதுல இன்னும் ஒரு ஒரு விஷயம் நான் சொல்லணும் ஐ ஜஸ்ட் வாண்ட் டு பாயிண்ட் அவுட் டு யூ கைஸ் வைல் வி ஆர் லைக் டுயிங் ஆல் தீஸ் கம்பேரிசன்ஸ் நம்ம ஃபினிஷ் செகண்ட் ஃபினிஷ் பண்ண சீசன்ல வந்து சிட்டி ஃபினிஷ் ஃபோர்த் அந்த சீசன்ல வந்து தி ஃபோர்த் ஃபினிஷிங் பாயிண்ட் வந்து 66 தான் எவ்ரி சப்சீக்வென்ட் சீசன் இட் இஸ் கண்டினியூஸ்லி இன்க்ரீஸ் அடுத்த சீசன் வந்து லிவர்பூல் ஃபினிஷ் ஃபோர்த் 76 பாயிண்ட்ஸ் வி வர் 1 பாயிண்ட் பிஹைண்ட் தம் அட் 75 தென் அகைன் லிவர்பூல் 75 ஃபினிஷிங் ஃபோர்த் அதுக்கப்புறம் டாட்டனம் 71 லாஸ்ட் சீசன் தான் செல்சி ஃபினிஷ் ஃபோர்த் வித் 66 பாயிண்ட்ஸ் ஸோ இது வந்து இட்ஸ் டெஃபினெட்லி நாட் கோயிங் டு ஸ்டே 66 ஐ திங்க் என்னதான் சொன்னாலும் வந்து ஈவன் இஃப் த டாப் டூ ஆர் லைக் பிரேக்கிங் அவே ஃப்ரம் எவ்ரி ஒன் 66 இஸ் நாட் கோயிங் டு பி த நம்பர் ஆஃப் பாயிண்ட்ஸ் இட் யூ நீட் டு பி இன் த டாப் ஃபோர் ஸோ ஐ திங்க் 76 டு 66 இந்த கேப் பார்க்குறப்ப ஐ திங்க் 70 டு 71 பாயிண்ட்ஸ் வில் பி எனஃப் ஃபார் திஸ் சீசன் டு ஃபினிஷ் ஃபோர்த் வாட் டு யூ கைஸ் திங்க்
Hey, Arunay, I think it's me. First, like, let me get back to this 2015. Okay, when we were lucky to finish in second. If you remember, all the top teams were terrible. including Manu. Manu was had a terrible season that time, and Liverpool was they were still building their team, and equally, all teams were okay around the season. Like, if you look, that's why I think that we ended up finishing second.
That's true.
I still remember, and we had a good chance of even leading Leicester, and Leicester were clinical in few matches, and they were scoring 1 and 2 zeros in last few matches, and that's how they ended up getting those title on that year. So the reason why I'm saying was we didn't do well that year, but we were little better than other teams. Okay. Understatement I want to put here.
Adana Fana Modele, we'll also consider all the other factors that happened.
Right. So with points, I mean, the trend now, I mean, looking at the first four matches, I don't know how the table is going to turn out. I could see a lot of other teams are playing really well. Leicester is doing well. I could see Aston Villa doing remarkably well after Barclay coming in. Top four teams, the fourth team finishing with 76 points, it's definitely possible this time.
So 70 assumption, it's yeah. Probably 75 would be good.
75, yeah, 70 to 75, yeah, that should be good, yes.
Okay, and do you agree, Arvind?
Mm-hmm. Yes, very much so. In a couple of encouraging signs from last season to this. Now, last season start panapo, we played a lot of the bottom half of the table initially, and those games there was a very consistent team. We were either trailing at half time or somehow at full time we would end up drawing the game. Either and it was predominantly chasing the game in the final 15 minutes, trying to get a point. The first four games later, the only top six team we faced is Liverpool. The other three teams are so far are below top 10. So with that said, even if we are generous, assuming that nam away to all top six teams and home to the top six teams, we don't perform. Abdin Vechikona, 36 points we are going to lose this season. I'm not considering Arsenal to be a top six team there. So technically we are putting a bracket of 7 teams. We lose 36 points. And the 36 points, the overall 38 games that reduced for now, it comes out to 80 points. And again, I'll give a couple of more games away just for the fun of it. I think we can definitely end with 75 or more this season. Especially after building the squad like this, an encouraging signs to begin with. We are definitely on the right track.
Okay. No, we'll come to know. Namo ipo Man City match will tell you. That's our Man City match a definitely parameter eduthukalam, like how which way we are progressing. See, if you see last year, if you're going to play Man City match away match, just imagine how we would feel, and you up adbe winning would be a miracle. Number or point drop panna adu vandu we could be considered lucky. Tokkuradhu kandipa adu definitely, that's what we'll expect, right? So in the aspect, now we feel little confident in going to Etihad, right? At least we know, okay, at least we can give up fight. I mean, that's what I feel.
Yeah, City haven't been great either, so.
Right, yeah. So what I'm saying is Man City, so the way how we are going to progress, we should have learned from the Liverpool match for sure. We were staying back. We really got hit by Liverpool in that league match. But I don't think that's going to happen with Man City match. But other parameter definitely eduthukalam, how we are going to progress in the match in the Premier League this season.
Okay, so how we are going to be progressing in the Premier League? At the point, we usually say your goals win you games, your defense wins you leagues. So adha difference na paaka povom next. Last time when in the defense when they conceded, if I remember right, just 36 goals. You know. So 36 goals conceded from a defense only. We already saw Czech. The other four were Nacho, Koscielny, Bayern, and either Mertesacker or Gabriel, Paulista. So, again, this time we have another Gabriel, and our settled defense, assuming that we go for a 4-2-3-1. I'm assuming it's going to be again Katie, Gabriel with either Lewis or Holding and Barron. So in the 4-2-3-1 board, okay, like between these two defenses, I know I'm not taking the midfield into consideration, but just at the defense level. So we'll talk about the midfield next, but just at the defense level, what do you guys think? Like in the comparison, that defense conceded just 36 goals under Wenger. Though we see a lot of defensive solidity, do you guys think that they're going to concede less than 40 goals this season or more?
Where I was going is, it's entirely different how I see. Okay. We could be able to gauge only when we start playing this back four. Okay. Appada vandu nammaloada and the strength enna nu theriyum. Right. Keeping the 3-3-4-3 on the formation, it is not fair to compare that. Upper number ardna 4 ko, ipo back order back 3 ko. But with the skill and what the physicality and with this evolving football and what is expected from the defense, I could definitely say that what we have right now is way far better than what we had in the year 2015. When we finish second.
So, up in the 3-4-3, do you think it will continue on? Like, when do you think we'll actually start playing 4-2-3-1?
We already started playing this four back four. I could tomorrow when we play with Man City, I don't think we'll shift to four. But as a
on
game
ball,
progress,
on the ball.
Yeah. And probably when we play the next team, when a mid-table team or something, we'll start playing this. After a comfortable 60 minutes or 70 minutes, I think we'll shift back to back four, and then I think we'll definitely try how team progresses when we shift to back four. So idu undu transition idhula ponu nenikiren, and then eventually we'll move to back four when we are really comfortable. So that's how I feel. So and with the defense, I could only say that we would be able to gauge the defense of what we currently have with 2015 only when we shift to back four. Back four la pathadha nammalku theriyum adu epin, but now it's safe because we know we are back three and easy on the idha cover pandradhilla correct ah irukku, that's fine. So that's why we are not able to attack quite often. We always have to stay back and then counter attack them anamudhi. Let's see how it goes when we shift to back four, and then that time we would be able to say how well it's evlo better nu solla mudiyum.
So ipo unna porthu vaikku we cannot you're saying that it would be unfair to gauge it at this point. Arvind, adhe point la da, like I understand it's unfair to gauge, we're playing like three at the back and we previously played four at the back the last time, but we are talking about all this defensive solidity and all that. So Praveen vandu, I asked him about the formation, so for you just a simple straight one, do you think we are going to be conceding less goals? Do you think this defense and the formation that we have has the ability to concede less than 40 goals or 40 goals, you know, maximum?
For sure. You know, one, I think the addition of Gabriel on the left side of the center back is definitely very helpful. He's got really good positioning. He's very strong and he reads the game very well. And that was one of the key areas where we conceded a lot of goals because David Luiz was playing in that position. He led all of Europe in conceding penalties. And on the position like a strength in Panadanala, I'm pretty sure we're the number of goals he conceded, one third abbe eliminate panirla. Even by that standards, you definitely looking at a lot fewer goals. I think the key, however, would be Tierney's ability to remain injury free. He's so far, he came mid-season last year, and his reputation as an injury prone player kind of precedes him. At 24, he's won a lot, but he's also been in the treatment table for a lot of occasions. I think that will definitely have an impact on how many goals we concede. Kolasinac has been good when he goes on the attack, but has been a suspect on the defense. So Tierney's injury would definitely have an impact. Gabriel, so far, he's not put a foot wrong. And, I think that'll be, that's a very good addition.
So, we sonna maari like, we don't leak a lot of goals. That's a very good point that you brought about. But at the same time, like I said, Tierney is extremely injury prone. So, we're going to be having large periods in the season where Lewis is going to definitely play a role. You know, even when we go back, if we go to a 4-2-3-1, I don't know, it's going to be between Lewis and Holding. And Holding is also like not great against pace. So, this is going to be difficult. I feel like 40 goals or whatever is going to be difficult. But on the 40 goals, another department plays a huge role, which is our midfield. So, last time, we did midfield comparison on the point on now. I just thought about the defense and the transitioning part of midfield first. So we had like either Ramsey or Santi playing that role with Cock in the middle. In the Vati Vati, we have Xhaka, who's been playing so far with either Ceballos. But again, we have Partey. So on the Partey, does it mean that we are going to be finally be able to, I know we spoke a lot about it previously too, but considering the whole team or aspect of Matarapo, the transition that happens from defense to attack, like what Praveen mentioned, we've been very solidly defending, but nothing's going on to the attack. And Partey is someone who could do that. We had Santi who was doing that. You know, Santi was all over the pitch. He would be like, you know, there's shit disturber going all around and getting the balls. Although the way in which he moved was unbelievable. But if a Partey in Kanada, it also provided over Mario the physical solidity. So in the transition, like they help Pani, and then will it also like prevent like, you know, attacks more than what we were doing at that time. So the 36 goals conceded from Nadella, the attacks that were coming in played a huge role. We were not always able to stop them. And the ability to improve, do you think like this will also help in transitions? Will we be better? Do you guys think we'll be better in terms of gameplay and transitions?
See, it all depends on where Partey is going to play. Okay. If Partey is going to replace where Ceballos is playing currently or Elneny is playing, playing with 3-4-3, I don't think we'll see a much progress. We'll still have a solid mid. We might not concede goals, but I don't think we would score more goals in that fashion. Inclusion of Partey will be beneficial only when we go for back four and keeping Partey and Xhaka and keeping Sabai on front. But if we're going to have this 3-4-3 formation continue for some time, I don't think we're going to have, we cannot see much improvement in how we're going to attack, but we might see a good difference in how we, epdi on the number different mandradhu na difference theriyum. But I don't think with attacking personnel, it's still going to be the same. So that's why I'm kind of excited. So how Partey is going to be used in Man City's match. I don't think he's going to start Man City's match. We never know. But Vara match, I want to see where he plays. If he's going to stay along with Xhaka or are we going to have a fluid transition between 3-4-3 or 4-2-3-1, that kind of formation. Based on that, we can see எப்படி வந்து ஆர்சனல் அட்டாக்கிங் இதுல எப்படி இருக்கும்னு தெரியும். பட் அதர்வைஸ் 3-4-3 வித் பார்ட்டே இட்ஸ் ஸ்டில் கோனா பி தி சேம் இன் அட்டாக் பர் சே, பட் வித் டிஃபென்ஸ் இட் வி கோனா சீ எ பெட்டர் ரிசல்ட்.
ஓகே, டு யூ ஹேவ் எனிதிங் டு ஆட் ஆன் டு தட் அவன்?
எஸ் சோ இன் தி சீசன் ஐ திங்க் ஸ்டார்டிங்ல இருந்தே ஒன் டீம் ஹஸ் பீன் வெரி கன்சிஸ்டன்ட். நம்ம அட்டாக்ல போறப்போ ஈவன் தோ வி ஸ்டார்ட் வித் அ பேக் ஃபைவ், நம்ம அட்டாக்ல போகும்போது ட்ரான்சிஷன்ஸ் டு அ பேக் ஃபோர், அண்ட் நம்ம டிஃபென்ஸ்ல வென் வி ஃபால் பேக் இட் ஆட்டோமேட்டிக்லி பிகம்ஸ் அ பேக் ஃபைவ். அண்ட் ஐ திங்க் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு சீ அ லாட் மோர் ஆஃப் தட் திஸ் சீசன். ஏன்னா ஈவன் தோ த பேக் லைன் த கேப்ரியல் ஹேஸ் பீன் அ வெல்கம் அடிஷன், தி அதர் பீசஸ் ஹூ ஆர் தேர் லாஸ்ட் சீசன் ஹூ கன்சீடட் தட் மெனி கோல்ஸ் ஆர் ஆல்சோ தேர் திஸ் சீசன். And you can take the bed sheet la irukra ota enna apdi da irukku, correct. So adinala we definitely need that extra insurance in the back, So having said that, even though நம்ம அந்த பார்ட்டி எடுத்துட்டு வந்து இட் ஹெல்ப் அஸ் கெட் டு தட் பேக் ஃபோர் ஃபார்மேஷன் வி ஆர் கோயிங் டு டிஃபெண்ட் இன் பஞ்சஸ் இன் தி பேக் பின்னாடி அஞ்சு பேர் இல்லனா ரொம்ப கஷ்டம் அண்ட் ஃபோக்ஸ் லைக் புக்காயோ சாக்கா இஸ் வெரி குட் இன் தி அட்டாக் பட் ஹி நீட்ஸ் டு பிகம் அ லாட் மோர் பிசிக்கல் பிஹைண்ட் அண்ட் யூ நோ ஹெல்ப் வித் தி டிஃபென்ஸ் சோ வித் தட் சைட் although I see us considering less goals, but it's going to be a fluid change between back four and the back five.
Okay. So continuing on, Praveen has had a work call and unfortunately he had to leave. But good news is that Rohi is joining us for the second part of the pod. So Rohi, just to get you up to speed, we're just doing a comparison between the squad from last time we were finishing in top four. That was 2016. So on the squad order, for current squad order, just compare for me. ஒரு சும்மா ஏதாவது ஒரு ஒரு விதமா let's see if we can get it to the top. So இப்ப பாக்குறப்ப வந்து we covered up to central midfield and we're all happy with what is happening in central midfield and party. But ஒரு முக்கியமான factor என்னன்னா அந்த season that was Mesut Ozil's like best season. Season வந்து he had 19 assists and 6 goals in total in the season only. And it could have been much more. Had we had a better striker to share. Ippo enna who's going to create these goals for us? Ippo yaar like who do we have in the department where Bappan Padala, who do you think will be creating the goals for us this season?
Yeah, so I think that is one aspect where we may struggle a bit, honestly speaking. Because there is no so இப்போ வந்து நம்பர் டென் சொல்லிட்டு வி ஹாவ் அ வேர்ல்ட் கிளாஸ் நம்பர் டென் பட் எனிவே இஸ் நாட் கோன் பிளே வித் அஸ் திஸ் சீசன் ஏன்னா அது முடிவாயிடுச்சு ஆல்மோஸ்ட் ஸோ இப்போ வந்து இன் டேர்ம்ஸ் ஆஃப் கோல் கிரியேஷன் இன் டேர்ம்ஸ் ஆஃப் மூவிங் ஃபார்வர்ட் இட் வில் பி மோஸ்ட்லி ஃப்ரம் த விங்ஸ் ஒன்லி ஸோ மேபி வில்லியன் ஆர் பெப்பே ஆர் ஒபாமங் தே ஹாவ் டு லைக் ட்ரிஃப்ட் இன் ஆர் தே ஹாவ் டு கம் இன் ஃப்ரம் த லெஃப்ட் ஆர் த ரைட் அண்ட் So, I'm just hoping that Partey can be that kind of an instigator from the back to the front. Like, ball a vandu konjo avanga half lengthu eduthittu to do that particular, or maybe Zaka can do a kind of a through ball, or Ceballos can do a kind of a through ball. Andu mottam dhaan namakku ore chance. Yena, current setup vandu Arteta adu vandu, if we are going with maybe 4-3-3 or 3-4-3, any of these two combinations, there is no possibility of a number 10 role. So there is no possibility of anyone who is going to have that kind of a pass put forward in the our final sprint. So it will be more of a fluid motion only. So if we follow the Liverpool concept, we will be number 10. But the number 9 comes a little bit behind. And basically he kind of plays that kind of a connector role for Salah or Mane. So, அது மாதிரிதான் வந்து either Laka has to come back or Willian has to be in that kind of a position. He has to like kind of drop back a little bit and then kind of open the space for Aubameyang to make those darting runs and then score. So, அது மட்டும்தான் நம்மளுக்கு ஒரே option. And we always know like Zaka has a very good ball and எனக்கு தெரிஞ்சு left hand side ல வந்து if you are going to be really strong, that's going to be our left hand side because you include Tierney, Saka and Aubameyang in the left. So, Tierney and Saka can basically do that overlapping run. Like, Tierney is known for his overlapping run against, and Saka can actually put the ball into the third quarter. So, அது மாதிரி இருக்கும்போது நம்மளுக்கு வந்து மோர் சான்சஸ் வந்து நம்ம லெஃப்ட் ஹேண்ட் சைடு தான் இருக்கும் சி அப்படி பண்ணோம்னா நம்ம ஒன் டைமென்ஷன்ல ஆடுவோம் சோ த ஓபனன்ஸ் வில் பி ஈஸிலி நோயிங் தட் அவர் பிளஸ் பாயிண்ட் இஸ் த லெஃப்ட் சைட் அண்ட் தென் தே ஈஸிலி பிளாக் அஸ் சோ வி ஷுட் நாட் பி கம்ப்ளீட்லி டிபெண்டிங் ஆன் தட் சோ I'm kind of looking forward like an interlocking position where the positions can basically interlock between each other and they can go forward. Adhu dhaan na paakkuren ipo. So, enakku therinji andha oru aspect la kandippa we will struggle this season in terms of who is going to create those chances. Because right now, it's very unclear.
ரைட் இப்ப ஒசில வச்சுட்டு நம்ம எப்படி வயர் எஞ்சிட்டு இருக்கோமோ அதே மாதிரி எங்க வீட்டு பக்கத்துல எங்கேயோ பத்தி தெரிஞ்சிட்டு இருக்குன்னு நினைக்கிறேன் ஒரே ஃபயர் எஞ்சினா சுத்திட்டு இருக்கு தட்ஸ் வை சோ அர்வின் லைக் விவேக் சார் இந்த ஃபார்மேஷன் அண்ட் பிளே நம்ம போகும்போது வந்து இட் டசன்ட் சீம் லைக் வி ரியலி நீட் அ 10 ஆர் மேபி யூசிங் அ 10 பட் மத்தபடி ஆப்ஷன்ஸ்னா த ஒன் தட் ஐ கேன் திங்க் ஆஃப் இஸ் செபாயோஸ்
Willock, Saka, and maybe Nelson. I cannot think of anyone else who could. Oh, yes, sir. Right. Mm-hmm. Yes, sir. So even Garko, we have five options and we have a pretty big season. For now only we played 4-5 matches and there's still a lot to play for. Who do you think could be a cheap creator? Not a number 10, but a creator, someone who can perform that role of maybe giving those assists Ruiz.
So I think ESR is a name that stands out. He had an impressive loan spell Huddersfield last season, and on the loan spell mudiyum bodhu is that manager couldn't stop praising him enough. And Vita Inur season couldn't edit it away, but Arteta stepped in and we know what happened. But I think he is poised to have a breakout season in our show. Although I don't know how much he will feature in the Premier League, but Europala, especially with the kind of group we have, it is an absolute, in the godsend in terms of us bringing our bench strength to the fore and trying to develop them. So we'll be able to see at the end of the season ESR evlo hype ke evlo how much it can come through. Personally, I feel Joe Willock can also be a creator. So far, he's played that traditional number 6, number 8, Andamari. He's been a box-to-box midfielder. I don't know how much he can evolve that game. He's not impressed me that much. But on the Anganga garbage time, he's shown that creativity. Last season, Carabao Cup, Liverpool against her, he scored that worldly goal. So I have a lot of expectations on him as well. He's very young, very moldable. He comes from Hayland, so we want him to succeed.
He's one of our own.
Yes, he's our own, right? And finally, I think to Rohit's point, and if we are playing that kind of a false nine with the striker coming back in, I think we need somebody else, or let me rephrase, we need Auba to be upfront than Lacazette. Because yeah. Lacazette, on the mele irunda, you're having Auba on the wings. And Auba is not that much of a creator. He's a poacher. He's an absolutely amazing finisher. And if you have somebody on the wing like a Pepe on the left side as well, where Saka could slot in, and he has that dribbling ability to get past defenders, play that ball, and having somebody like Aubameyang up front not only increases the number of finishes or your completion percentage, it also gives you that extra person to be played in the midfield who has the ball handling skills. And not the first touch of a Romelu Lukaku.
yeah, that is true. Yeah, Arun, I just want to add one more point. In that.
Sure.
So, like how Arun said, right? So, the most ideal scenario would be like, let Saka play on the left, Pepe on the right, Willian in the center, and Oba in the front. That kind of a thing may work out for us. Kandipa, yena, adu vandu, maybe Laka can come around 60 minutes or anything like that. But Willian, if he is able to, I don't think Willian is that effective. I mean, like, except for one match against Fulham, other three matches, I don't think Willian was any effective in the wings. In the last match, when Pepe came on, Willian came towards the center, and that time we had kind of a little bit, I mean, he was having more touches of the ball, frankly speaking. So, and the option was in the Kandipa Pakra. So on the left hand side, if you are not able to see, if you are going to play three at the back, then put Tierney a little bit front and then play Saka. So after Irkum Bode, I think then we would be having some kind of a thing going forward.
Okay. So, Iblo midfield option discussed, but we are still playing a 3-4-3. So let's assume that something happens. We eventually go to a 4-3-3 somewhere in the middle of the season. So, yeah. Who do you guys think would be a three, midfield three?
Ceballos, Xhaka and Partey. That would be a midfield three. That will be a best midfield three for the season. I mean, no doubt. Elneny, Elarmi, Irupanga, AMN, Elarmi, Irkalam. But our best mid three is these three. That's it.
Do you agree, Arvind? Actually, in the question,
I agree with you that would possibly be our best midfield three. Saka is naturally left-footed, and Partey is naturally right-footed. Base of the midfielder, they'll be very effective. Ceballos has shown the creator instincts a little bit. So on the number 8 role, what Aaron Ramsey did for us, Dani Ceballos can definitely replicate that, in my opinion. And of course, number midfield options, we can have AMN as a backup. Elneny is a midfielder. He can come in. Joe Willock can come in. ESR can come in. Indamari players now, Chirikov. To be honest, Mesut Ozil has one more year in his contract and he's not going to be re-signed. He's not a world beater anymore. And we lack that number 10. But on the number 10, Kaga, Mesut Ozil Avaladi, you're going to ruin the kind of play that Arteta wants to be playing, where you expect everybody to track back and even the goalkeeper to go up front to sometimes score goals. So, andamari or reformation or style of play like Komod, there is honestly no place for Ozil. And we can use this as a prime chance to, bring our talent from the academy, the youngsters, give them the chance at least 20 to 25 minutes a game, see what they're about.
Okay. So, in Swanna Persona, like the fluidity of the system and the possibility of even a goalkeeper scoring a goal. You know, the series are Sonia, the Vandidika Sonia, but we'll definitely be needing a lot of people to score goals because we're coming to the attacking department. In last season, the number of goals that we scored was just 56. We scored just 56 goals last season, out of which Aubameyang scored 22. தலை வந்து பாதி கோல் அவரே போட்டாரு. அந்த லாஸ்ட் சீசன் வென் வி ஃபினிஷ்ட் இன் த டாப் 4 2016, வி ஸ்கோர்ட் 65 ஆர் 66 கோல்ஸ், 65 கோல்ஸ். ஓகே, சோ 65 கோல்ஸ்ல வந்து சான்செஸ் வாஸ் ஸ்கோர் 13, சான்செஸ் ஸ்கோர் 13, ஜிரூ ஸ்கோர் 16, ஹி வாஸ் டாப் ஸ்கோரர், அண்ட் ஓசில் ஸ்கோர் 6. சோ பிரிட்டி மச் அகைன் ஹாஃப் த கோல்ஸ் ஆர் கமிங் ஃப்ரம் தி 3, ஃப்ரம் தோஸ் 3, ரைட்? So, if we have an amazing striker in Lacazette, and we have like a great striker in Aubameyang. We know how what these two guys are capable of. But these were the two guys who were playing last season as well, and we scored just 56 goals. Where are we going to be getting the goals from? How is it evenly distributed, or is it going to be all Aubameyang again? Based on whatever we've seen so far, and what do you think would be the situation? Anyone can go.
Okay, I'll take it. So I think this season, even though we have had a lot of expectations on Aubameyang, especially after him signing the new contract, we've scored 8 goals in 4 games this season. Only one has come from Aubameyang, that world-class goal against Fulham. But apart from that, the other 7 have been scored by somebody else, which is in itself a very encouraging sign. Four goals now, when you have less than 20% goal contribution from your potent striker, I think that signals a kind of a shift in terms of mentalities. This also says something else about teams who are trying to overload Oba, who are trying to put double man him or put more bodies on his side of the field. It is opening up the other side. You see, yeah. 8 goals now, 5 of them have come from the right side. Only 3 of them have come from the left. So, again, that signals, there are more men on Aubameyang's side and not as many on the other side. I think that is an in-game change that Arteta has done absolutely splendidly. And I think that is the difference between us winning the games against the bottom half teams we faced so far and trying to fight for a point.
So, Rohi, do you think in the goal distribution will be even, or is it going to be like Eddie saving the season for us?
Yeah, that may be a possibility also. I mean, you never know. But yeah, so what Evan said was that is true. Like basically, in the season level, just one goal Oba had scored out of all the goals which we scored in the first 4 games. So that says a lot. Like and also. Maybe, I don't know, are we missing out on Oba playing in the front? That is another, you can talk about that another day. But I feel personally that it will be shared this time. I don't think Oba will be able to score 20 plus goals this season, for sure. I don't think he'll be, it's very difficult for him to replicate the same thing if you're going to play in the same system.
Mm-hmm.
So, in the system, la vandu 20 goals score pandrathu vandu left side la it's going to be a bit difficult. So, that's what I feel. So, it's going to be shared. So, and I personally feel like, idhu munnadiyum pesirukom, I personally feel at least Pepe should be able to score at least 15 goals this season. He will score 15 goals. So, Edi is going to score at least 12 goals this season. So, we have, we are competing in four different leagues, right? I mean, like four different formats we are competing. So, Kandipaga, Eddie, Martinelli, all those guys are going to play a very important role for us in this season, in terms of like scoring goals.
Cool, okay. So, one assumption that we have done, Rohit, like, average, like, last four seasons, five seasons, we just checked, like, what was the minimum amount of points required to finish in the fourth position. So, in the path, we decided that it's going to be around 70 to 72 points that will get you the fourth position. Okay. So, 70 to 72 points is a lot. It's not easy to get. So, we have the team, we have a very good team, but do we really have a very good squad to compete and finish in the top four? Like, you know, bench on that plays a very important role over the 38 games.
Yeah, yeah.
The number of competitions that we participate in, like you said. Though we don't want to participate in certain competitions, we are being forced. So, the Carabao Cup, Karmala, Ramala, do you think we have the bench to actually go and, like, you know, mount a proper top four challenge? Me, Sonamari, Gabby is there and, Nelson, Saka, Willock, all these guys are going to play a big role. Eddie's also going to play a big role. So, do you think we have the bench strength to actually go ahead and mount the top four challenge?
I don't think we have the bench strength, first of all. If you want to compare with the 2016 season, we had almost six midfield options, which comprised of Arteta, Cazorla, Ramsey, Coquelin, Alex Oxlade-Chamberlain. இவங்க எல்லாருமே இருந்தாங்க. சோ ஐ மீன் அட் ஒன் பாயிண்ட் எனி கிவன் பாயிண்ட் ஆஃப் த டைம் சம்வேர் இன்ஜோர்ட் ஆர் சம்திங் லைக் தட், பட் ஸ்டில் அந்த ஆப்ஷன்ஸ் வந்து கண்டிப்பா இருந்தது. ஐ மீன் லைக் வி ஹேட் லாட் ஆஃப் ஆப்ஷன்ஸ் டியூரிங் த 2016 அண்ட் அட் த ஃப்ரண்ட் யூ ஹேட் சான்சேஸ், வால்காட், ஓசில் அண்ட் ஜீரோ. சோ எனக்கு தெரிஞ்சு வந்து வி ஹேட் அ பெட்டர் ஸ்குவாட் இன் 2016 அண்ட் ஐ மீன் இட் மே பி கான்ட்ரவர்ஷியல் பட் எனக்கு தெரிஞ்சு டெஃபினெட்லி வி ஹேட் அ மோர் பேலன்ஸ் ஸ்குவாட் இன் 2015. த ஒன்லி திங் விச் வி ஆர் லேக்கிங் வாஸ் எ டிஃபெண்டர் லைக் கேப்ரியல், numbers 8 like Partey, or only those areas we were lacking. So Coquelin was injured like almost like for 5 or 6 months. Ava aadna irukku nalla da aadna ana adukapra injured aanu
namma appa aadna the zero oda adhu evlo
periya adhu da. So and the season ku thotha ore kaaranam zero mattum da, that and that drought he had got during that peak, I mean namma February, March, April, those 3 months. See, we were 2 points behind Leicester, right? In January, we were just 2 points behind Leicester. So, we could have easily, and Leicester had to play so many top 16s that time. Now, chances, we drew so many matches because we were not able to convert our chances. Now, we couldn't finish because we had a lamppost for a striker.
The situation on there when we are doing this, it, like I said, we've always faltered, you know, in the end, we've always flattered the disease come February, March. Our campaign is complete on the final, Arvind. Do you think, like, what is your dream? Do you think we can turn up the challenge for top four? Number one, number two, number three, number four, number five, number six, number seven, number eight, number nine, number things happened which resulted in, you know, City faltering, Madrid faltering, Chelsea, Liverpool, everyone faltering. That helped us. So, if we want to leave Liverpool and City alone, you know, like those two were confirmed. Which are the teams that were when you compare our squad with one of the others, do you think in that aspect we have a chance for going to
City? I think it's too premature to say just leave Liverpool and City alone. Liverpool are one Virgil van Dijk injury away from imploding. City haven't had the best start to the season. 2011, Lende, this is the second time they've had the least number of points in the first three games. And the Mario situation, it's tough for me to just say I'll hand over Liverpool and City as one and two of them. And so first come. I'm not saying Arsenal are going to be title holders at the end of the season. I'm just saying it's too premature to just hands down and give it to Liverpool or City.
Arvind, how did the AFC tie in with the
I'll also back my other assumptions with logic. This season, United haven't had the best of starts. United don't look like a top 6 team. I'm fairly certain. I think I'll probably put money on the fact that OGSP is going to be fired this season. So I can safely write them off from top 6. Everton has been a standout performer this year, but I don't know how much they can sustain because they've had new signings and their squad depth is not so great. Calvert-Lewin, Pinardi, there is no potent striker. There is not that number 2 that they have. Calvert-Lewin has never finished a season fully. He's always been injured. So I don't know how much I can trust Everton. Leicester City. Leicester City have had the most number of chances that they have squandered next to Arsenal. So Avanga, again, somebody who can I put them in top 6? I don't know. Chelsea, they have massively invested in their striker options. But their defense, nammalavada kevalamana defense ortanga appadina adu Chelsea da. They have a Lamborghini for an attack and the Karagatakara car for the defense. யாராச்சும் ரிட்டையர்மெண்ட் ஹோம் ஹாஸ்டல்ல பத்தி சொல்லட்டுமே, ஏன்டா டேய் விஆர்எஸ் வாங்கிட்டு போனவெல்லாம் கூட்டு வந்து வச்சுட்டு என்ன. Again, see, all these teams I just named do not have, and finally, before I forget, I'm a North London rivals. Tottenham Hotspurs, again, they try to invest in their squad a lot. They don't have a creator as much as we don't. And anybody behind Harry Kane, I don't know who that second person is. So, they're also a bit of suspect. I think this season, we are primed to finish top 3 lap. We have a squad, amazing squad.
கொஞ்சம் கம்மி பண்ணிக்கோ இவ்வளவு வேணாம், கொஞ்சம் கம்மி பண்ணிக்கோ இவ்வளவு வேணாம்.
லாஸ்ட் டைம் நம்ம செகண்ட் ஃபினிஷ் பண்ண 2015-16 சீசன்ல பாத்தீங்கன்னா லிவர்பூல் வேர் ஜஸ்ட் ஸ்டார்டிங் டு பில்ட் அண்டர் கிளப். சிட்டி ஹேட் மேனுவல் பெலெக்ரினி. யுனைடெட் ஐ திங்க் யுனைடெட் தட் வாஸ் தேர் லாஸ்ட் செகண்ட் சீசன் அண்டர் வாங்கால். அண்ட் செல்சி ஐ டோன்ட் even know what the hell they were doing. And Spurs, Mauricio Pochettino, golden generation, again, if you look at the same themes that are happening this season, we can draw a lot of similarities. And based upon that is what I'm saying, Arsenal are going for the kill.
Okay. Buying up a diary, I wish I had half the confidence that you do. I'll be a winner in life, honestly. So final thoughts. Top 6 candidates. Who are all your top 6 and relegation candidates? Predictions. Rogi.
In order. Okay, in order. Okay, that's going to be difficult. But Everton will be finishing in top 6 definitely this time. Our squad depth in Galo, I'm kind of like hoping on Ancelotti, because Ancelotti is a class manager, he's a world class manager, and he knows how to target. And James Hammers Rodriguez vandu gaandla vandu bayirama aada aarambichana adukapra romba kashtam matha teams ku, ena vandu he vandu rendu moonu season Real Madrid vandu he was an outcast there. So if he wants to prove something to the world, so this is going to be the breakthrough season for him. and they have a good striker and they Walcott ellarume irukanga team la IOB sadana IOB vera aad aarambikiran enak puriyala epdinu but appa so Everton I am going for Everton for sixth position. This may be sounding a little bit difficult, but Arsenal may come in fifth. So, Arsenal may come in fifth, yes. So, I am not requesting a prediction in the sixth or seventh, but I am rooting for Arsenal for fifth. So, number 10, we are going to go top four. So, fourth, I am going for, unfortunately, Spurs. அவங்க டிஃபென்ஸ் என்னதான் மட்டமா இருந்தாலும் அவங்களோட மிட்ல இப்ப கூட தே ஹாவ் வேர்ல்ட் கிளாஸ் பிளேயர்ஸ் காண்ட் யூ கேன் நாட் I mean, you cannot deny it. They have Kante, they have Howard, they have so many good players in Chelsea squad. So, I'm going for Chelsea for third. Second is going to be City. I think Sotter is going to struggle this time. But he has got the squad depth where he can trust upon. And definitely he is going to finish in top two. Again, winning this title this year. Enna 6-1 adi vaanginaalum, Liverpool is going to win. This time. So this is my top six prediction.
Okay. I'll go to you, Arvind. Quick top six prediction.
Okay. I am going to make the assumption that Virgil van Dijk is going to remain healthy throughout the season and I give Liverpool one. It's going to be a tough toss between Arsenal and City for 2 and 3. I'm sorry, Arsenal and Chelsea for 2 and 3. And I'll back my logic. Arsenal and Chelsea are two of the most complete squads. Forget squad depth, complete squads start to finish. And Chelsea or a defense might be it's a suspect, but I feel they have the attack to outscore teams. We saw that in the West Brom game. So I give the edge to Chelsea. So I'm putting Chelsea second, Arsenal third. I got City finishing fourth, and that is basically because they don't have a number nine. Jesus is injured. Aguero is 33, coming off a major knee injury. Father time's real. He's not getting any younger. So I don't see how City have it in them to score, that many goals. We saw the Leeds game. They were mightily exposed. Pretty sure Arsenal's going to exploit the same weakness next game, especially with no KDB. They do not have an edge. And then my fifth is Everton. I'm putting Everton here, because of the way they've started the season. I don't think they have the legs to finish the season, but I have a lot of respect for Carlo Ancelotti, the manager. So I'm going to put them fifth. And, my hate for Spurs and the fact that I think United are far worse than how Spurs are this season. I'm putting Spurs sixth. Again, they do not have, the squad depth that, the other five teams I talked about have. They do not have a creator. Their, center back combination, highest average age of the Premier League, the league is built on pace. So I don't think they have the ability to sustain the entire season, especially playing Europa.
Okay, எப்பயுமே நெகட்டிவா பேசுற ரோஹித் கொஞ்சம் பாசிட்டிவானு பார்த்தா சும்மாவே பாசிட்டிவா இருக்காரு, பயங்கர பாசிட்டிவா செகண்ட் எல்லாம் வருவான் சொல்றான். Okay, my predictions would be, I think Liverpool and City would be top two again. Chelsea would finish third because of their attack. But fourth, when we have a chance, we'll be fighting with, I think, United, possibly. Probably would finish third, or Leicester sixth. That's mine. Okay, so relegation, any predictions for relegation? Three predictions without any explanations. Just three teams. Can you get three teams?
So my three teams are going to be Sheffield, Burnley, Fulham or West Brom, depending upon who is not able to score more goals.
You, Rohit?
Yeah, I'm going with Fulham, West Brom and Burnley.
Okay, that's pretty much my choice as well. Fulham, West Brom and Burnley. Okay, so last one, I think we're coming to the end of the process now. We have a game against City on Saturday. So, any predictions for the game? Any surprises you think we'll be having in the starting lineup? Okay, let's go with the predictions. Rohit.
So I'm giving 2-1 for City.
2-1 for City. Any surprises in the lineup?
I may see Eamon coming in.
Okay. Okay. And Arvind.
I think 3-1 Arsenal, 1-0 at halftime. We are going to score the second goal around the 60th, 65th minute. I'll give a City consolation goal at that point. And finally, when City are throwing the kitchen sink at us, we can sneak a counter. 3-1 Arsenal.
I don't know what you had for breakfast, lunch and dinner, but like I said, I wish I could be half as positive as you are. So, predictions, I think from my end, it's going to be either 3-1 loss for us. We'll play well as we did in the Liverpool game, but we'll end up coming short at the final end. Okay, so, edo method which we predicted, we've done something saying that we'll probably have a good chance of finishing in the top four. First spot start from the 8th and 9th in the season, no? Our podcast will number one, so that's a big positive for us. Relegation predictions and City match. So City match, I think, will be a good one. But in the longer scheme of things, we will need this to get better. So eventually, it was wonderful having you both on this podcast. It was a really good discussion that we had. It was great having doing the first part with Praveen as well. And hopefully, we'll be able to use one of these squads from now on, this year or the next 2 years, and do a comparison with the title winning squads from then. So, there is something that obviously all of us want to happen. So, here's cheering to that and hoping that it does come true in the near future. So, thanks a lot, guys. Thanks a lot for listening to this episode, and we'll see you in the next one. Thank you. Thanks, Arvind and Rohit.
Yeah, thank you.
Come on, you Gunners!
Thanks a lot for being with us for this episode of UPR, your weekly Arsenal Tanglish podcast. We'll be back again next week with more interesting topics, so stay tuned.